This is high school basketball on Frontier Community Access Television.
Goes around his men. Nice play by Ben Lowe. Lasoski on a runner is good. A running hook shot. Wow. Horn pull up jumper for 12 is good.
Left side. Lowe will step up for three. Book it. Back to the right side. 3-point bomb put up and in.
Robinson. Three ball is good for Brandon Robinson. Downtown.
Left side. 3-point bomb put up. It's good.
It goes to Lowe. Lowe for three. Good. To Spencer. Spencer spots up for three and good. Oh, Lowe. Very deep. Pretty hit. Downs to Lowe. Three ball is good. Put back by Parsons is good. Lowe. Spin move in the paint. Off the glass and in. Pull up jumper. Blocked. What a play by Lowe. Came over and just knocked it out of the sky.
Frontier Red Hawk basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. Today's game, the Athol Red Raiders take on the Frontier Red Hawks. Hi again, everyone. This is Chris Collins along with Matt Carlson courtside. As tonight, the Frontier Red Hawks take on a struggling Red Raider team that's only won one game this season, Matt Carlson. And last season, Frontier pretty much had their way with Athol as well as earlier this year. Red Hawks would like to have the same situation happen tonight.
Yeah, they certainly would. Last year, we're getting reports from the players. There was a 25 to 30 point difference between the two teams earlier on. Frontier is going to be needing help from their leading scorers, Miles Freeman, Trevor Gilmore, and Ben Lowe. And their offense will be led by Keaton Warren tonight.
The players that have impressed me this year for Frontier have been the front court players of Karsten Carey and Jacob Meyer, sophomore and a freshman. They're going to be with this program for a couple of more years, and they are absolutely the front court of the future for the Red Hawks. Red Raiders come in here with a record of 1-12, 1-8 in the Hampshire League. Frontier comes in 4-11, 4-7 in the Hampshire League, squarely on the bubble for a postseason tournament berth. Upcoming, Athol versus Frontier from Goodnow Gymnasium. It's next on Frontier Community Access Television. Good, that was fun.
Now for tonight's starting lineups. First for Athol, at guard, number 3, Justin Blake. At guard, number 21, Isaac Ralston. At forward, number 24, Jordan Chapalonis. At forward, number 2, Evan Siza. And at guard, number 4, Tyler Boyd. Athol is coached by Dan Beavis. And now for Frontier, at guard, number 1, Keaton Warren. At guard, number 15, Trevor Gilmore. At center, number 22, Carsten Carey. At forward, number 13, Miles Freeman. And at forward, number 3, Ben Lowe. Frontier is coached by Ben Marszewski. The officials for tonight's game are Nate Burdick and Robert Hager.
Right, here we go. Hampshire League play. Athol Red Raiders in town to take on the Frontier Red Hawks. And welcoming aboard, Matt Carlson. Matt did a great job on the wrestling meet the other night, which Frontier won handily. So we thought we'd give him a chance to try out basketball. And so welcome aboard, my friend. It's good to have you here. I get lonely sometimes doing these games because I'm all by myself. So we're good to have another voice in the broadcast.
Thanks, Chris. It's a great opportunity.
Now, I know you'll have some, hopefully, some insight into some of these guys. You know these Frontier guys pretty well, much better than I do. But we may have some dramatics to start this game, which we'll talk about if it happens. But Frontier coming out here tonight, this is a game they should win. This is an Athol team that has not been real competitive this year. They've got one win on the season. But anything can happen in high school basketball. And Karsten Carey is going to jump center against Chapalonis of Athol. They're ready to rock from Goodnow Gymnasium. Ball is in the air, and it's controlled by Frontier. Keaton Warren to Miles. He went up for the dunk, and it gets fouled. So that was the drama we were talking about. Miles Freeman was going to go for a dunk off the break. Instead, he gets the foul. The Frontier players, Matt, were throwing it down pretty good in between the JV game. You're not supposed to dunk in warm-ups, but it wasn't really their warm-ups, so it didn't matter.
Yeah. I saw 3 or 4 dunks, actually.
Yeah, that's 3 or 4 more than I've seen in the last 2 years. First shot by Freeman is no good. Second one is no good. Rebound pulled down by Isaac Ralston. And here we go. Ralston running it right side. Warren on him. Hands it off to Blake. Blake over to Siza. Siza drives through, running shot in the lane, no good. Carson carry the rebound, knocked loose, but he gets it back. Carry outlet to Warren. Frontier wants to run quick. Warren, right side to low. Ben, right corner to Freeman. Freeman, jumper from the edge. It's good for three. 3-point field goal. 3-0 Frontier. Ball thrown ahead to Blake. Blake gets a lane by Carey, lays it up, and spins out. Tough break. Rebound pulled down by Freeman. He gets a knockdown. And ball picked back up by Champalonis. And they'll set it back up. Ralston now. Right corner to Blake. Blake drives cross court and gets bumped. I believe they're going to get Warren or Lowe on the foul. We'll see who they get. That's on Keaton Warren, his first, team's first. 7:02 to go in the first quarter, 3-0 Frontier. Ralston now. On a high post to Siza. Siza, right side to Ralston. He'll spot up for three, spins out, no good. Back to Siza. Siza trying to drive the baseline. Carey cuts him off. Nice play by Carson Carey. And here comes Trevor Gilmore. Gilmore, pull up from three. Back iron, no good. Rebound, put back, is good by Miles Freeman. So Miles has come to play. He has all five of the points for the Redhawks. Now a little backcourt pressure by Frontier. They break it, but just barely. That's going to be a backcourt violation. Threw it away. Yeah, tough break there by Champalonis, Matt.
Yeah, we're looking for a big game out of Miles Freeman tonight, you think?
Well, Miles definitely is, you know, he's already on the board. It's Miles 5 and Athol nothing at this point. Carson now. Over to Freeman. Freeman in the corner to Gilmore. Gilmore, that's his spot. Spins out, no good. Rebound pulled down by Lowe. Lowe's jumper over everything. Air ball. And the rebound pulled down by Blake. Blake runs it up the floor for Athol. Behind the back dribble. In the middle to Ralston. Ralston tries to go right side. In the middle of Champalonis. Champalonis in the high post. And Keaton Warren with the quick hands. Pokes it away. Warren lays it up and it's good. 7-0 run for the Redhawks. 5:51 to go in the first quarter. Now Blake. Up ahead to Ralston. Ralston tries to feed the lane. Can't. Pulled down by Carey. And here comes Keaton Warren. Warren, bounce pass to Freeman. Freeman off the glass, no good. Put back by Lowe is good. And Athol wants to call time. Good idea. Timeout on the floor. We'll take the break. 5:32 to go in the first quarter. On the scoreboard, all Frontier. Redhawks 9, Athol nothing. This is Redhawk basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. Redhawk basketball brought to you in part by Holy Name of Jesus Parish in South Deerfield, a national Catholic parish, by the South Deerfield Polish American Citizens Club, always big supporters of Frontier Redhawk athletics, and by attorney Daniel F. Graves of Deerfield. He's Deerfield's town moderator. He's also a lawyer in Greenfield. Call him for legal services anytime you need some. So as we expected, Matt Carlson, Frontier coming out very, very strong, 9-0, a 9-0 run for the Redhawks.
Yeah, it looks like we're seeing some of that Frontier defense to start the game off with.
Absolutely. Great defense, and we often talk more about the offense, but the D has been really good in this first few minutes. Now Keaton Warren trying to hassle Ralston again, and he's going to get past him. Ralston runs the right wing and gets stripped, just absolutely stripped by Keaton Warren. Warren ahead to Lowe. Lowe lays it up at in, and the Redhawks are firing on all cylinders right now. And the inbound pass... It was an error, apparently, but I think it's going to come back. It's a Frontier ball. The Athol player did not get the ball in, so bad to worse for the Red Raiders. Warren inbound, throws it out to Freeman. Miles in the corner to Ben. Ben over to Keaton again. Back to Ben Lowe. Lowe tries to feed Miles Freeman on the baseline. Shot up off balance, no good. Gilmore the rebound, back to Lowe. Lowe goes 1-on-3 off the glass and in for Ben Lowe, who's got 4 points. 13-0. A 13-0 run to start this game.
looks like we're about to see a big game for Ben Lowe as well.
Yeah, Ben Lowe's definitely come to play. These guys, they know. They can make things happen against this Athol team for sure. Ralston trying to drive on Gilmore, falls down, and they're going to get Gilmore on a foul, I think. Yep, that's going to be his first, team's second. 4:36 to go in the first quarter, 13-0. Athol has yet to register a point. We saw the same scenario with the girls' team against East Hampton the other night. Ball lobbed out to Tyler Boyd just into the game for the Red Raiders. Boyd in a high post to Blake. Blake tries to drive through, stripped on the way up. Ball is loose, knocked around, and picked up by Karsten Carey. Great D again by the Redhawks. Warren ahead to Lowe. Lowe to Carey. Give and go. Lays it up and in. Oh, they're doing everything right tonight. 15-0. Redhawks have come to play. We're going to get some new Redhawks into the game. I think a line change is coming up here. Ralston now trying to drive on Warren. Warren gets a screen. Now a deep three by Boyd is no good. Ball knocked loose. Gilmore recovers. Gilmore up ahead to Lowe. Lowe drives through, dishes it inside. Beautiful dish to Freeman. He got hacked on the way up, though. And Miles Freeman's going to go to the line. Foul's going to be on Chapalonis. Maybe you can explain what's going on with Miles Freeman's hair.
Miles.
What is with the thing in the front there, that little ridge?
Oh, I'm not sure, though.
Front of the iron, no good. Wholesale substitutions coming in for the Redhawks. Into the game, we have Meyer. We have Jared Muzica. Also, Alex Sharp into the game. Alex Sharp's gotten some good minutes for the Redhawks after coming up from JV. Second shot is good, and that's going to be Miles coming out, and he'll be replaced by Ben Listowski. 16-0, as our friend Oz might say. 3:41 to go in the first quarter. High post. And it goes back to Angel Rivera, just checked into the game, to Blake. Running a bit of a weave here. Ralston over to Rivera. Rivera deep in three-point land. Tries to pass it on the corner to Chapalonis. Stolen again by Frontier. Sharp. Now in the lane on the baseline. Laying it up and in is Jacob Meyer. So Frontier really spreading the points around here. A lot of different players in the book already. 18-0. This is not the start that Danny Beavis wanted for his Athol Red Raider team. Three ball, and they're finally in the book. Three-pointer by Isaac Ralston. Makes it 18-3. Now Kyle Spencer. Right side to Muzica. Inbound pass to Meyer, and he gets fouled over the back. And we'll see who they get here. Third team foul on Athol. And they're going to give it to Chapalonis. That's his second. Inbound pass to Listowski. Stosky over to Spencer. And a pass batted away, intended for Meyer, goes out of bounds. Still going to be Frontier ball with 22 seconds left on the shot clock. Jared Muzica to inbound for the Hawks to Kyle Spencer. Spence runs it right side. Over to Sharp. Sharp in the corner to Muzica. Tries to feed Meyer and a whistle and a foul. So that looks like a set play. They're trying to dump that ball down to Jake Meyer. It's three or four times they've done that.
Not surprised with that height he's got over there.
Yeah, I mean, he's like I said, that guy's the center. He and Karsten Carey are the future front court of this Red Hawk team. The next couple of years are going to be fun to watch those guys together.
He's got an extra year, too, because even though he's a freshman, he had already completed his freshman year at another school.
No kidding.
Yeah,
so,
he transferred over.
So that's great. Even better news. Sharp to inbound to Listowski. Now a three ball by Spencer. No good, pulled down by Sharp. Sharp to Meyer. Great passing into Listowski, lays it up and in. That's just textbook right there. 2:16 to go in the first quarter, 20-3. Redhawks on pace to score 80 tonight. We'd love that. Ralston now to Rivera, deep three. Back iron, no good. Rebound pulled down by Listowski. Outlet to Kyle Spencer. Spencer, right side. And again, dumping it down a little. Meyer all alone on the baseline. Somebody might want to put a body on him. Timeout on the floor. And Athol Red Raiders are reeling right now. 1:50 to go in the first quarter. All Frontier, Red Hawks 22, Athol 3. This is Red Hawk basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. This is exactly what Ben Barshevsky wanted to see out of his team to start this game. 22 points already. We still got 2 minutes to burn here in the first quarter. Miles Freeman has 6 points in this game. He's on the bench right now. That knee is wrapped up pretty well. You know something about that?
Yeah, so it was a late season football injury that he was struggling with, and he was actually out for a few games, came back, and he played in the first drive of the Mohawk game, but then he just made it back for basketball season.
Yeah, and he's lucky that Aaron Landry missed part of this basketball season because of an old football ankle injury. And he's been out there a couple times. He's always a crowd favorite. Another guy that people go nuts for is Luke Parsons. When Luke Parsons hits the floor, people are going to freak out. The last couple of games, he's got huge responses. He's always one of those guys who's a crowd favorite. Angel Rivera now crossing the timeline for the Red Raiders and tried to pass it to who, I'm not sure. It ended up in the hands of Jacob Meyer. And now Sharp has it. Sharp crosses half court to Spencer. Back to Sharp. In the corner to Muzika. Muzika in the middle to Spencer, who just pops it from 12. 24-3. Now Ralston in the middle of Blake. Blake tries to get it to Siza. Siza tries to go one-on-two against Meyer and Listowski and draws the foul. So Evan Siza will go to the line for the Frontier Redhawks, or for the Athol Red Raiders, excuse me. Today's game being brought to you by Holy Name of Jesus Parish in South Deerfield, a National Catholic Parish. First shot misses everything, no good. They'll get one more. Size's second shot is good. 24-4. Frontier by 20. 1:11 to go in the first period. Sharp. Left side to Spencer. And now a pass inside to Muzika. Turnaround layup is no good. Rebound pulled down. Listowski tries to drive through, lays it up. Gets fouled on the way up, so Benny will go to try and get a couple of shots the hard way. Ben Listowski, very impressed with his game. He's a solid player. He has great basketball smarts. This is the first shot. He gets a lot of time off the bench. Doesn't usually start, but makes great contributions. Second shot by Ben is good. He has 3 points in this game. Less than a minute to go in the first quarter. 25-4, Red Hawks by 21. Rivera goes left side to Boyd. Back in the middle to Ralston. Ralston tries to drive, pulls it back to Boyd. Boyd to Rivera. Rivera for three. Deep three is good for Angel Rivera. And what do we have here? Foul away from the play. Yeah, that's going to be a foul away from the play. Who did they get? We will see. We'll see what they post. Sharp now bringing it up. 33 seconds to go in the first quarter. Sharp to Spencer. In the corner to Listowski. Back to Spencer. Tries to lob to Sharp on the baseline. Sharp turns it back around to Meyer. Great passing. Spencer back to Sharp. 12 seconds on the shot clock, 16 on the game clock. Listowski in the wing. Turnaround jumper by Meyer. Spins out. Tough break. Rebound pulled down by Athol. 10 seconds to go. Raiders will play for one shot. Big deep three. Spins out. No good. That one was way out there by Ralston. They lob it ahead, and that's how the first quarter will end. We played one quarter here at Goodenough Gymnasium. At the end of one, all Frontier. Red Hawks 25, Athol 7. This is Red Hawk basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. Second quarter upcoming, 25-7, the Frontier Redhawks. And I don't think they're going to get there, Matt Carlson, but they're on pace to score 100 points in this game. Now, that would be tough to do against anybody, but that's the pace they've set for themselves. A pretty great first quarter.
Yeah, it's a terrific first quarter. One thing that they're doing this game that we really haven't seen them do much this year is they're hitting all their easy shots.
Yeah, they really have. They had not a lot of misses and great passing. Ryan Olmstead, Noah Graves into the game, along with the aforementioned Luke Parsons. And also Brandon Robinson into the game. And Aaron Landry. So this is a team that doesn't get a lot of playing time, this unit together. But they're going to now. Foul on the way up on the shot. And they're going to say that that was a possession foul. So Athol will inbound under the basket. Ball inbound, shot from the corner is no good. Rebound pulled down by Athol. Red Raiders may have more success. Oh, they airmailed that pass all the way into the audience. The Red Raiders may have more success against a less experienced lineup like this, but we'll see. Here come the Hawks. Noah Graves, left side to Ryan Olmstead. Olmstead goes cross court back to Brandon Robinson, McTravel. Brandon Robinson is a junior. We didn't see much of him last year. I don't know if he's new to the program or not, but he didn't do much last year.
No, he's been playing basketball for all 3 years of his high school career so far.
Pass goes through the hands of the Red Raider player, and Brandon Robinson has it. Brandon Robinson runs the right side, fires it up and in. Great play by Brandon. So everybody getting into the act tonight. For Frontier, 27-7, largest lead of the game, it's 30. 7 minutes to play in the half. A little bump and run shot is no good. Rebound pulled down by Parsons. Handed off to Graves. Right side to Brandon. He shoots the three, he shot it before, I've seen him do it. Turnaround jumper from the corner by Olmstead catches the front of the iron. Rebound pulled down by Athol. Ralston now brings it up. Ralston trying to work on Robinson. Double team. Robinson bats it away. Ball's pulled down to Graves. Ball hits the floor. Athol picks it back up, though. Ralston tries to feed the paint, and it's pulled down by Frontier. There's nothing working for Athol right now. Robinson now with the ball, top of the key. Left side to Noah Graves. Back to Olmstead. Olmstead drives through, gets stripped on the way up, gets it back. Tries to feed the paint to Landry. Now a jumper from the corner by Robinson's no good. And the follow-up putback is good, so they stuck at it. I didn't see who got that bucket. Was it Landry? Did not see who got that. We're going to give it to Aaron. I think it was him.
Yeah, I didn't see
it. Driving the baseline is blocked. Rebound pulled down by Brandon Robinson. Actually, I think it might have been Noah Graves that got that bucket. Pretty sure it was. Timeout on the floor. We'll take the break. 5:46 to go in the half on the scoreboard. It is the Frontier Redhawks 29 and the Red Raiders of Athol 7. This is Red Hawk Basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. Broadcast of Red Hawk Basketball will come your way next week, weather permitting. The Turner Falls Indians are going to come to town and take on the Frontier Red Hawks. Always a good rivalry game. That'll be scheduled for next Tuesday night. Although I don't know if that game is going to happen because there's a threat of inclement weather. The weather has really wreaked havoc on the schedules for high school sports this winter, much more so than in past years. A lot of ice storms, which are no fun at all. Unless you happen to be a school kid that doesn't want to go to school that day. In this case, they're great. Left side pass to Olmstead. Olmstead to Aaron Landry. Landry back to Robinson. Robinson dishes through, lays it up. Nice move, but didn't fall. Rebound pulled down by Ferrari just into the game for Athol, and a foul on Aaron Landry. Aaron still thinks he's on the football field, I think. Very physical. When he's in there, he's tough to move around.
Oh, yeah.
And you can see he's just solid as a rock. You guys must spend quite a bit of time in the weight room together.
Oh, yeah. You got to when you're a 1,000-yard rusher.
That's exactly right. Shot up as an air ball. Rebound pulled down by Olmstead. Olmstead to Robinson. So this second unit by Frontier is doing pretty well against the starters of Athol. Robinson dishes it back to Graves. Graves stops, pops, hits. Good little hesitation move there by Noah. Got his guy up in the air. 31-7. 5 minutes to play in the half. Will Athol get to double digits before the half ends? We will see. That shot up was an air ball. Rebound pulled down and a possession arrow favors Frontier. You don't see a lot of those tie-ups. A lot more those tie-ups happen in girls' games than boys' games, but there was one there. Graves right side to Brandon Robinson. Olmstead. Olmstead dishes to Luke Parsons. Parsons, a reverse layup!
Yeah.
And that's going to blow the place up. Luke Parsons looking like AI on that one. 33-7. Right side to Siza, drives the baseline. Siza's shot up is partially blocked. Olmstead pulls it down. Outlet to Robinson. Brandon ahead to Parsons, but it was stolen away nicely by Rolston. Here come the Raiders. Rolston trying to dish it off. Deflected. It was off Rivera. They're going to say it was off of Graves, so it's going to go the way of the Raiders. Quick substitution for Athol. 22 seconds left on the shot clock. Siza is out, and Blake is in for Athol. Blake now with the inbound pass being guarded by our friend Mr. Landry, and he gets called for a blocking foul. Of course, Aaron will be back next year on the football. That's three fouls on Aaron. He's going to have to come off. I didn't see the first one, but three quickies, and Aaron will sit. He'll be back. Worthley's back. And, of course, Captain Matt Carlson back on the gridiron next year.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Big things next year. Big things.
Three-pointer by Mark Ferrari is good, and that gets Athol into double digits, 33-10. What kind of big things can we expect?
We're going to have a young line, or we're going to have a returning backfield, so it should be good thing, good news.
Three-pointer there for Brandon Robinson's good news. That makes the score 36-10. Rivera now. Cross-court to Blake. Blake bounce pass in high post to Mason. Mason's jumper is no good. Rebound pulled down by Muzika. And Noah Graves now. Almost got his pocket pick. Noah stays with it. To Robinson. Robinson gets a little daylight. Dishes it off. Parsons from the foul line shot is no good. Gets his own rebound. And Rivera steals it back. But what are they going to say? Not going to be a foul. I think I don't know what happened there, but I thought the Athol player slipped on the baseline, but the referee is going to explain it to Ben Barshevsky, and now they're going to bring it back. Referee Nate Burdick gave him an explanation. I'm not sure Ben liked it, but we're going back the other way. Three-point bomb by Blake is no good. And Graves pulls down the rebound. Noah to Jeremy Zika. Jared goes behind the back dribble, loses control, gets kicked ahead. Battle for it, and it's going to be a foul on Brandon Robinson as he blocked off Ralston. I was kind of hoping they'd dive for it. I always like when they hit the ground for the ball. Hustle points. Speaking of hustle, we'll get it out of the way now. Who do you like in the Super Bowl this weekend?
Oh, I'm a Patriots guy all the way.
All right. Worried about that Atlanta offense, though. Not worried about the Athol offense right now, but the Atlanta offense I am. Olmstead over to Graves. Graves to Parsons. Parsons back out to Robinson. Robinson to Muzika. 13 to shoot. Olmstead drives the baseline. Reverse lay-in is no good. A little bit of showtime happening out there right now. Some of these plays by Frontier. Rolston now. A three-pointer over everything by Rivera. And it's pulled back down by Robinson. 2:15 to go in the half. 36-10. Robinson bumps into Parsons, but Parsons gets it back. Too strong on the layup. Robinson, the putback rebound, no good. Second putback, count it and one, as Brendan Robinson was not to be denied. That's one thing Frontier has done very well this year. They rebound very, very well. Part of the reason is they have a tall front court. But then a lot of it's hustle right there by Brandon Robinson.
Takes a lot of athleticism to do that, doesn't it, Chris?
It absolutely does. Absolutely does. And I like the way Brandon Robinson's playing in this game. A lot of very good individual efforts by the Frontier Redhawks and collectively as a team as well. Robinson going for the three-point play, and he hits it. And Brandon already has 8 points in this game. 38-10. 39-10, rather. 2 minutes to go in the half. Rivera tries to go around Graves, dishes it back to Siza. Siza goes through, gets bumped, no call. Siza hits the ground. Blake trying to jimmy his way through, can't. Parsons steals, up ahead to Graves. Graves pulls it back, dishes to Olmstead, fakes the three. Oh, he wanted that three. Back to Graves. Graves trying to drive through, jump step over to Robinson. Robinson drives the baseline, tries to dish inside. Back to Olmstead. Jumper inside the iron, no good. Rebound is pulled down by Robinson. Robinson tries to drive through, but gets shut off and bumped, and a foul. And I believe we are into the 1-1 as we have reached the, actually that's the 18th foul on Athol, so it'll be a 1-1 for Brandon Robinson. Robinson, his first shot is good. He'll get one more. Today's game being brought to you in part by the South Deerfield Polish American Citizens Club. Proud supporters of Frontier Athletics. Second shot is no good. Rebound pulled down by Blake. 1:22 to go in the half, 40-10. Redhawks. Blake feeds the paint. Shot up by Ferrari, too strong. Rebound pulled down by Athol. Driving through his size, rejected by Parsons. Great timing by Luke Parsons. Graves to Robinson. No luck pass on the baseline to Parsons, and he gets fouled. Wow, great passing by Frontier. How about your buddy Parsons with the rejection? Who knew he could get up that high?
Yeah, I had no idea.
You and Luke are pretty tight, right? You're buddies.
Yeah.
Parsons, first shot, front of the iron, no good. He'll get one more. That's the first team foul on, the first foul on Siza, 19th foul. Second shot is good. So Parsons makes one of two. He has 3 points in this game. Minute to play in the half. Siza trying to run through, and they're going to call a blocking foul as Olmstead gave himself up a bit there. Thought he had the lane locked. Did not. Siza will get go to the free throw line for two shots. Evan Siza's first shot is no good. He'll get one more. It's only the first foul on Olmstead. Team seventh for the half. Second shot by Siza is all net. 55.8 seconds to go in the first quarter, first half rather. And Graves ahead to Robinson. Robinson to Muzika. Back to Parsons. Parsons lost the dribble, and it's stolen back by Athol. Mason lost control and just dribbled it off his leg. And Frontier will get it back. 38.3 seconds left in the second quarter, 41-11. Frontier has already almost eclipsed their point total from last year in this game. Robinson into Parsons. Parsons trying to work on Siza. Lays it up, reverse lay-in. No good. And Rivera traveled.
Looks like this is the most offense they've generated in a half all year.
It certainly seems like, certainly for the games we have seen. And, you know, there have been some nights where they've been in the 40s for an entire game. Right now they're pacing to get into the 80s. Robinson for three, spins out. Rebound pulled down by Ferrari. Now Blake to Rivera. 6 seconds left. Rivera to Siza. Siza trying to drive through, lays it up and in. Nice play. And that will end the first half. We've played a full half of basketball here at Goodell Gymnasium. On the scoreboard, Frontier Redhawks well in front. It's Frontier 41, Athol 13. This is Red Hawk Basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. We are at the half at Goodnow Gymnasium, and the Frontier Redhawks well in front of the Athol Red Raiders, 41-13. Chris Collins along with Matt Carlson. Well, Matt, pretty much what we expected. We knew it was going to be a tough go for the Red Raiders against this Frontier team. But I love what Frontier is doing. A lot of different people in the scorebook, and they're making their shots, which is the most important thing.
Yeah, it's important. They're having that frontier defense, and they're making all their easy shots. They're not making any mistakes. They're not turning the ball over, and I think that's why they're winning by 28 points.
Wow, by far more, the most kids I've seen in the first half in the scorebook all year for the Frontier Redhawks. Brandon Robinson leading all scorers with 9 points, 6 for Miles Freeman, 4 each for Ben Lowe and Jacob Meyer, 3 for Luke Parsons, 3 for Ben Listowski, and 2 each for Keaton Warren, Kyle Spencer, and Karsten Carey. For the Red Raiders, 4 points for Evan Siza, 3 for Angel Rivera, 3 for Isaac Ralston, and 3 for Mark Ferrari. Frontier Redhawks have to do something kind of crazy in the second half not to win this game, but what's interesting also is the starters played the first couple minutes, but really it's been a lot of the reserve players getting some key playing time in this game that carried most of the play in that second quarter. So second half action upcoming. Right now the Athol Red Raiders trail the Frontier Redhawks by a count of 41-13. Second half action upcoming on Frontier Community Access Television. Second half action upcoming as the Frontier Redhawks lead the Athol Red Raiders by a count of 41-13. The starters did not play a whole lot in that first half, and then that begs the question, in a situation like this when you're up by 28 points, you know, and you're a coach, how do you not let your kids play, but you don't want it to become a disgusting blowout that's, you know, that's really upsetting to one of the teams. It's well, tough.
I've had coaches say that it's important for my starters to at least get a half of football.
That's football.
But that's football. That's a different story here.
Well, you guys blew some people out this year, and I don't think it was – I don't ever got the sense that Dom was running the score up, but and I don't think Ben will do that either.
Well, when you run to the 6 and the 7 hole, what are you going to do, right?
Exactly right, and nobody can stop it. I mean, that was some crazy numbers that those guys put up this year. First shot by Athol is no good. Warren gets the rebound and over to Ben Lowe to Gilmore. Frontier starters back in the game to start this half. Shot up is no good by Freeman. Rebound pulled down by Athol. And the Raiders come back the other way. Blake over to Ralston. Ralston trying to drive on Warren. Stopped. Ralston to Blake. Top of the key. Blake feeds the paint to Champalonis. Tries to go around Carey. Shot up no good. Karsten the rebound. Outlet to Miles Freeman. Back to Keaton Warren. Almost out of bounds. Keaton saves it. And Frontier will set up the half-court offense. Warren now, right side to Miles. Miles, pull-up jumper just inside. The arc is good for two. 43-13, lead back up to 30. Ralston trying to move on Warren. Stays with it, dishes it down low. Shot partially blocked by Gilmore. Rebound pulled down by Freeman. Freeman threads the needle looking for Ben Lowe. Back to Carey. Carey all by himself. A nice little touch, lays it up and in.
Looks like the starters are back in, Chris.
Yep, the starters for both teams are back in, but oh, the airmail pass to the corner to Boyd. Boyd over to Siza. Siza trying to drive through, running hook shot, gets fouled on the way through, and it's going to be on Miles. And Siza will go to the line to shoot two shots. It's Miles' first, team's first of the half.
This will be a good opportunity for the younger kids to get experience that they wouldn't usually get playing a tougher team.
Absolutely, and that's exactly the point. When in a situation like this, when you're against the team that you're pretty much handling, get those young guys in there and get them some playing time. Second shot is no good. He misses them both. Carry the rebound, outlet to Ben Lowe. Back to Keaton Warren. Keaton now between the circles. On the play. Bounce pass down low to Freeman. And they got a foul. That's going to be on Champalonis of Athol. His fourth, team's first. Gilmore gets the inbound pass all by himself. Shot no good. Freeman battles for it, tries to save the ball. Can't. And Athol will go back the other way. .550 to go, third quarter, 45-13. Frontier well in front. Ralston right side to Blake. Back to Ralston. Ralston driving through on Warren. Dishes it back out to Boyd. Boyd, top of the key. Boyd to Blake. One little weave. Blake trying to muscle his way through. And shot up no good. And we're going the other way. I think that one thing we're seeing Athol probably doing a little too much individual stuff, trying to go through two and three Frontier players. That's not going to work with guys that size, like Karsten Kerr.
No. And I think that that's one thing that Frontier has changed, is that they used to be doing that in the older games this year, but now they've figured out how to play as a team, and that's why they're putting on a show today.
Well, as you go through the season, you learn things, and you know you get used to each other. Shot by Lowe is partially blocked. Back out to Warren. That's part of the emergence. Carey, turnaround jumper and triple coverage, and hits it! Three men on him, they couldn't stop Karsten Carey. 47-13. And now a little bumping foul on Keaton, as he's been jousting with Ralston tonight. And that's going to be a possession foul, second foul on Keaton Warren, second on the team. Ralston gets the inbound pass. Trying to feed the paint. Goes over to Boyd. Boyd in the corner to Siza. Siza trying to move his way through. Blocked by Carey. Clean block. And Gilmore brings it back up the floor for Frontier. Left side to Keaton. Warren trying to drive. Pull up jumper in the lane. He gets fouled on the way up. And Keaton Warren will go to the line to shoot two. That Keaton Warren is so quick, man. Just a real quick ball player. Going to be a second foul on Siza. Two shots for Keaton. First one is good. Tonight's game being brought to you in part by attorney Dan Graves of Deerfield. He's Deerfield's town moderator. He's also a lawyer in private practice. Call him at his Greenfield office for all your legal needs. Second shot by Warren is good. Makes them both. 49-13. 4:29 to go in period number three. Ralston brings it up. Driving through, running one-hander is good. Nice play by Justin Blake. That makes the score 49-15. Warren, left side to Gilmore. Gilmore trying to drive, shut off. And pass is blocked by Champalonis. That is stolen back by Frontier. Gilmore to Warren in the corner. Shot up no good. Rebound put back by Freeman is no good. What did I miss?
Looks like there's some subs about to check into the game.
Oh, yeah. Well, another line change. Three-point bomb for Siza. Yep. Timeout on the floor. We'll take the break. 3:29 to go in the third quarter on the scoreboard. Frontier 49, Athol 18. This is Red Hawk Basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. Don't forget, coming up in a few weeks' time, the Frontier Regional School Telethon, which is a big deal. I know you're very much involved in that, Matt. That's going to be a lot of fun.
Yep, March 30th.
March 30th of this year, yep. And lots of talent on display. And we're going to have it live, I believe, this year, as we always do on Frontier Community Access Television. You mentioned before, Matt, this is a relatively young Frontier team, and the future looks mighty bright.
Yeah, looking at how the second team has been playing tonight, it looks like in the next few years they're going to go places.
Yeah, absolutely. And we mentioned the front court. We mentioned a lot of different things. The future is definitely bright. But last couple of years, the thing that Frontier has been missing is that real powerful scoring touch. They've got every other element of the game, but the scoring has always been sort of suspect. But they've got good athletes, that's for sure. Rostowski into the game. Air mails a pass coming right toward us. Make sure our camera didn't get knocked out of the way there for the scoreboard camera. Otherwise, are we good? All right. Ball will be Athol's to start this next exchange. This is Ralston in the corner. Three ball by Blake is no good. Battle for the rebound and knock loose. And this is going to be on Athol. It's going to be on Tyler Boyd. And we're going back to the That's the first foul on Boyd, team's third for the half. Alex Sharp now with the ball, cross court to Spencer. Kyle gets a lane, kicks it back out. Now gets the pass inside. Turnaround jumper is no good, out of bounds. And it's going to stay with Frontier with 14 seconds on the shot clock. Sharp to inbound. Lobs it out to Listowski. Can't control it, and Athol takes it back now. A home run pass ahead to Blake, who lays it up and in. Nice move by Athol. 49-20. Sharp now. With the ball, goes cross court. Right side to Listowski. Listowski feeds Meyer. Meyer kicks it back out. And a jumper in the lane by Spencer is no good. Rebound pulled down by Frontier. Fresh shot clock. Now Meyer gets fed on the baseline, lays it up and in. That's tough to defend. 51-20. 2:17 to go in the third quarter. Blake to Siza. Siza tries to feed the lane, can't do it. And Spencer gets it back over to Sharp.
Looks like Coach Barshefsky has been animated as usual this evening.
Always is, but in this case, it's a good animation. He's not like running up and down screaming and yelling because they're doing everything right tonight. Meyer, nice little dish is good. 53-20, 33-point lead, largest of the game so far for Frontier. Ralston, deep three, nope. Deep rebound comes back out to Sharp. Sharp, probably the point guard of the future for this team. Right side to Siza. Siza goes cross, excuse me, that's the Spencer, excuse me, goes cross court. No good, rebound pulled down by Athol. Over to Ralston. Left side to Boyd. Tyler dishes it off to Ferrari. And now Blake feeds the paint, looking for Boyd. Can't hang on, Frontier takes it back. Minute to go in the quarter, 53-20. Sharp brings it up, right side to Listowski. And holding foul in away from the ball. It's gonna be on Athol. Couple of substitutions for the Red Raiders coming in. Colby Mason's back into the game, as is Angel Rivera. Third foul on Justin Blake. Sharp lobs it out to Listowski, top of the key. Listowski drives through, penetrates, no good. Gets his own rebound, though. Lots of rebounds tonight for Frontier. Listowski now on the right wing, lobs inside to Muzika. Shot no good. Muzika follows the rebound and gets it. Just owning the boards tonight. 30 seconds left in the third. Ralston, high post to Siza, back to Ralston. Right side to Rivera, launches a three. Back iron, no good. And the rebound pulled down by Muzika. Out to Sharp. Sharp's gonna hold for one shot. Shot clock is off, 11 seconds left. Sharp runs right side, gets a screen from Meyer. Over to Listowski, 2 seconds left. Listowski shot, air ball. Rebound pulled down by Athol, and that's how the quarter will end. We played three. Goodnow Gymnasium on the scoreboard, the Frontier Redhawks 55, the Athol Red Raiders 20. This is Redhawk Basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. Quarter upcoming, Frontier Redhawks well in command of this one, 55-20. Chris Collins, Matt Carlson, and Alec Eckel back here at Goodnow Gymnasium as the Redhawks are going to cruise to victory. They're going to get their fifth victory of the year. They need five more to be able to get into the tournament. But one of the things you mentioned off air, Matt, which I think is an interesting point, is the depth of that bench has really helped out tonight.
Yeah, I think it's played a huge factor, the fact that the Athol Red Raiders have been gassed the entire time, not getting much of a break, and then Frontier has three full lines that they've been switching up.
Yeah, you can actually see the Frontier, the Athol players over there. They look gassed. We've only got a couple of subs, and numbers help. Three-point field goal there by Isaac Ralston, his second three ball of the game. Gets them off to a good start to the fourth quarter. Brandon Robinson down low to Olmstead. Olmstead in the middle to just checking into the game. Landry's shot is no good. Rebound pulled down by Ferrari. Gives it back to Ralston. Ralston to Ferrari. Left wing for three. No good. Landry the rebound. Good position on Siza in that one. Graves right side to Robinson. Brandon. Now it's passed down low to Parsons. Luke tries to feed the baseline to Landry, who gets hit. And that's going to be just out of bounds off of Athol. So Robinson to inbound. Brandon throws it into Graves. Graves to Parsons. Parsons running through to Robinson. Shot up no good. Rebound pulled down by Athol. Lead pass ahead to Rivera. Rivera shot is blocked by Robinson. And it's pulled down and a foul. They're going to get Siza, I think, grabbing the Frontier player. It'll be a possession foul. No shooting on that situation. That's three fouls on Evan Siza. You're right. I'm looking over at the Athol bench. Those three guys that are over there are gassed. I'm looking over at the Frontier bench. He got like 10 guys down there. Numbers are helpful.
And right now, Frontier's third line is playing up against Athol starters.
Yeah, and they're holding their own. They have all night. Olmstead, little baby hook is good. Ryan, nice play. 57-23. Ralston now. Runs right side, stops. Top of the key to Ferrari. In the corner to Rivera. Rivera, deep three. Good. Yeah, he's shown he can shoot that shot. 57-26. Frontier by 31. Graves now. Right side to Olmstead. Olmstead in the middle to Robinson. Robinson back out to Parsons. Parsons being guarded closely over to Graves. Graves left side to Robinson. Robinson drives through. Nice play, front of the iron, no good though. Athol controls the rebound. This is Ralston. Ralston kind of a wild shot over everything, kind of an air ball. Rebound pulled down by Frontier. 5:37 to go in the game. Noah Graves stops. Left side to Landry, to Parsons. Parsons got pocket picked there nicely by Ralston. Good play. And Athol comes back the other way. Baseline drive by Siza draws the foul. No bucket, but he'll go to the line for two shots. Siza's been out there pretty much the whole game. Man, when you have three subs, you haven't got much choice but to keep your best guys out there.
Yeah, I mean, the Athol Red Raiders are coming up on their 30th straight minute of basketball.
Yeah. Siza's first shot is good. They get one more. That foul was on Brandon Robinson. That is Frontier's third team foul, his first. Siza's second shot. Rims out. But the rebound pulled down by Ferrari. Athol gets a fresh 30. Now a deep three by Ralston is no good. Rebound put back is stripped. Ball knocked loose. Everybody hits the floor. Nice pass to Luke Parsons. Parsons a hook shot but fouled on the way up. And that gets a big charge out of the crowd. As I said, Luke Parsons is a crowd favorite here. But that was Robinson who hit the ground to keep that play alive. Nicely done. And that's four on Siza. One more and he's cooked. First shot is no good. Parsons will get one more.
It's nice to hear some of the names we don't usually hear around here, huh?
Yeah, no, it's good to see a total team effort getting involved. Parsons' second shot is good. Makes one of two. He's got 4 points in this game. 5 minutes even to go, 58-27. Ralston now, top of the key being guarded by Graves, loses control. Rivera picks it back up. Rivera trying to move. Left side to Chapalonis. Tried to feed the paint and it's stolen back by Parsons. Calling that name a lot tonight. Graves now. Nice pass on the baseline. Shot up no good by Landry. Oh, what a great pass. Robinson gets the rebound. Pull-up jumper from 12 hits.
He's had a game, hasn't he?
He absolutely has. Brandon Robinson in this game has 11 points. I think he leads all scorers. Inside pass to Colby Mason, who shoots it and hits. Left side pass to Olmstead. Loses control. Mason gets the ball back, and Olmstead tries to steal it back and overcompensates with a foul. So if I'm not mistaken, well, that's going to be a possession foul. That's the 14th foul for Frontier. Rivera, left side to Ralston. Ralston in the corner to Chapalonis. Back to Ralston in the corner to Rivera. Rivera, three-pointer at the top of the backboard. Parsons pulls down the rebound. Parsons losing control. Gets it back up. Hands it off to Graves. Graves drives through. Put up jumper. Hits the side of the iron. No good. Rebound pulled down by Athol. Ralston now bringing it up for the Red Raiders. Ralston in the corner to Ferrari. Back to Ralston. Ralston feeds the paint. Turnaround jumping. Hook shot is good. Nice job by Chapalonis to hit that. 60-31. 3:18 to go in the game. Noah Graves now to Parsons. Parsons back to Graves, top of the key. Graves over to Landry. Back over to Noah. 9 seconds on the shot clock. Graves to Parsons. Parsons, a hook shot. Back of the iron, no good. That would have brought the house down. Rebound pulled down by Athol. Ralston over to Rivera. Over to Ralston. Ralston trying to drive through. Over to Ferrari. Jumper from the corner is no good. And again, Parsons with the rebound. That's about his 7th or 8th rebound, I think, tonight. Olmstead to Parsons for 3. It's good. Best game I've seen Luke Parsons play this season.
Oh, yeah. How many points is that? 7 right now?
He has, that is 7. Passing the lane, stolen back by Olmstead. And a whistle. Because I think there was a foul behind the play. And if that's on Chapalonis, that's it for him.
These backup players are playing well, considering the fact that they've had so many games where Frontier was trailing, so they didn't get much experience.
Absolutely. And this is, like I said, you mentioned it before, and you're absolutely right. These kinds of games are an opportunity. As Chapalonis fouls out, an opportunity for these players to get real game experience. Olmstead's first shot is good. You will get one more, the 1-1. It's kind of unfortunate that you have to do it at the expense of a weaker opponent, but it's an opportunity nonetheless. Second shot is no good. Blake the rebound. And you got a feel for these Athol players. I mean, short bench, long year, only one win, but they're competing all the way to the very end. Three ball by Ralston's no good. Rebound pulled down by Aaron Landry. Up to Robinson. Less than 2 minutes to go. Left side to Olmstead. Olmstead baseline pass to Parsons. Parsons turnaround jumper. He got partially blocked by Ferrari, but also Ferrari got some hands, so Luke will go to the line. With a chance for a 1-1. Actually, they gave him 2 shots, I think, here because he was in the act of shooting. That's 3 fouls on Ferrari. Parsons' first one, front of the iron, no good. Tonight's game being brought to you in part by Holy Name of Jesus Church in South Deerfield, a national Catholic parish. Second shot by Parsons is good. That's 8 points for him in this game. 65-31. Now a dish off to the left side, and it's going to be a double dribble by Tyler Boyd as he bounces the ball back in frustration.
these Red Raiders got to be careful with the penalties with that short bench. Yeah. Not too many players can foul out.
That's absolutely true. I don't think anybody's in serious foul trouble at this point, but you're right about that. A little weave pass to Graves. Graves to Olmstead off the glass and in. Great passing by the second unit. They have been, in many ways, more impressive than the starters in this game. Rivera right side to Parsons, to Ralston. Ralston tries to feed Rivera on the baseline, goes past him, and we're coming back the other way. 1:06 to go. Graves now crosses half court. Noah drives through, dishes back out to Olmstead. To Parsons. Parsons shot, front of the iron, no good. Graves the rebound, put back off the glass and in. Everybody getting in the act tonight in terms of scoring. Less than a minute to go, 69-31. Frontier does not often score into the 70s. They'd love to tonight. Ferrari's three ball is no good. Parsons rips down the rebound. And with it, Blake. And it goes back to Robinson. 30 seconds left. Robinson right side to Graves. Will they try to get into the 70s? Let's see. Noah Graves, cross court to Robinson. 14 seconds shot clock, 21 seconds on the game clock. Graves, it's a screen from Olmstead, tries a pick and roll, can't do it. And Rivera takes it away for Athol. 12 seconds left. Rivera is just going to jack up a three. He'll make it. That's 9 points, three threes for Angel Rivera, and that is how this game is going to end. Final score from Goodenough Gymnasium, the Frontier Redhawks 69. The Athol Red Raiders 34. We'll come back and wrap it up on Frontier Basketball on Frontier Community Access Television. So a big win tonight for the Frontier Redhawks as they knock off the Athol Red Raiders by a count of 69-34. By far the best offensive output of the year, I think, at least in the games we've seen, Matt Carlson, from this Redhawk team. It seemed like everybody was getting into the act tonight.
Yeah, no one was making mistakes, everyone was hitting their easy shots, and they were moving the ball around. They were giving everybody an opportunity to score, and that really helped them a lot in this game.
By far, the most players we've had in the Frontier broadcast in the book, scoring-wise this year. Leading scorer was Brandon Robinson, who I think has really been a bit of a find this year. He's a junior, but a solid basketball player. He had 11 points, 8 points for Luke Parsons, 8 for Miles Freeman, and 4 for Keaton Warren, 2 for Kyle Spencer, 4 for Ben Lowe, 5 for Ryan Olmstead, 6 for Noah Graves, 3 for Ben Listowski. Jeremy Zika had 2. Miles Freeman had 8. Luke Parsons had 8 points. Karsten Carey, 6, and Jacob Meyer had 8 points for the Frontier Redhawks. For the Athol Red Raiders, leading scorer was Angel Rivera, who wound up with 9 points, 3 three-pointers. 8 points for Evan Siza, 6 points for Isaac Ralston, 2 for Tyler Boyd, and 2 for Jordan Champalonis. So a lot of fun tonight for the locals. The Athol Red Raiders lose to the Frontier Redhawks. Redhawks grew to 5-11 on the season, 5-7 in league play, still in the playoff bubble, but a lot of basketball still to play. I want to thank Matt Carlson, my broadcast partner, for joining me tonight, and for Alec Eckel, and the executive producer of Frontier Regional Basketball is Kevin Murphy. I'm Chris Collins. The final score for the final time, the Athol Red Raiders, or the Frontier Redhawks rather, 69, the Athol Red Raiders 34. So long from South Deerfield on Red Hawk Basketball.